Welcome back. Well, from redesigned areas to an expansion of programs, the Grand Forks YMCA is excited to reopen the gym to its members today.
Abby Furchner got a special inside look this morning.
Well, good morning, you guys. I'm here at the YMCA in Grand Forks, where they're going to have a busy next 3 days as they're having their grand reopening. And I'm here with Patty McEnroe, who is the marketing and membership director at the YMCA. And let's just talk about what people can expect when they come out to the Y. What did you guys redesign and remodel?
Well, we took our fitness area and kind of and basically rearranged it, and we brought our equipment, our boxing equipment, our Parkinson wellness program equipment up to the main level, and we took our heavier weight plate loaded strength equipment, brought it down to the lower level. So
because I know that a lot of your remodeling, you wanted things to be more accessible, so is that why you decided to do the flip-flop?
Yes, we had this beautiful space downstairs, and it was great for our Parkinson wellness programming. But, you know, with people with limited mobility, we just wanted to make something a little safer and easier for them to get to. So that's why we came up to the main level.
Well, that is just great in itself. I know this boxing area now, too, you guys everyone is kind of able to access it as well.
Yes, this area is accessible to our general membership, and we are actually offering a beginner boxing class so people can learn how to box safely. We want everybody to be safe. We know a lot of people want to use the equipment, but they might not have a boxing background.
And there is so much more, and so we're going to turn over to Sean Reich, who is the fitness center coordinator. And when it comes to one-on-one training, does the Y offer that here?
Yep, we sure do. We offer personal training, but we also have a new program called the Y Medical Fitness Program. And so basically, we offer free training for individuals with qualifying medical condition who aren't able to physically or mentally exercise on their own. So I am certified in working with special populations, and I'm here Monday through Friday from 8 to 4. And so members who are interested can sign up with me, and I can create an individualized program that's right for them and progress from there.
So. And did you see a need for those in the community when they came to the Y? Was this kind of a need you were starting to see here at the gym?
Absolutely. There's a huge need. Many types of individuals have cardiovascular disease, MS, stroke. So we see a lot of, people with those types of conditions. And so to have them continue to exercise and helpfully improve their condition, at least manage it better overall, I think that's a great thing. And so, yes, there is a need, and the Y is a great place to have them get started. So.
And so, Adam, I'm going to turn to you. This is Adam Sorum, the Healthy Living Director. And I just want to talk about a little bit more about the boxing area, because there is so much to offer. Like we said, now everybody can use it. But there are some programs here, too, that are new to the facility, too.
Absolutely. We have our beginner boxing program that Patty touched on a little bit. It goes through how to wrap your hands up, how to use a heavy bag, how to use an agility bag, a speed bag. It's a comprehensive program that is taught by a former competitive boxer. Really learning how to do all the different components. And I myself have taken it and have learned a lot, so it's really a fun class. You get a good workout, and you also get to get your aggression out a little bit, so that's really fun. We also have in this area a self-defense class we brought in too, taught by David Murphy. He teaches Hapkido. Hapkido is a self-defense technique that uses large movements so that you don't have to be stronger than the person you're defending yourself against, but it's a real self-defense class. So I think we're really looking forward to adding more and more things to this area.
And really quickly, too, I want to touch on the equipment that you guys have as well. That is all wheelchair accessible, and people can use it of all abilities.
Absolutely. We have multiple wheelchair accessible machines. We have nice machines like our new step that people can transfer on. That's lower impact for their joints. We're looking at bringing in more machines, different machines. We're just trying to really make accessible our equipment. We've spread the machines out so they can fit walkers or wheelchairs. So we're trying to be a complete facility that can serve all of our community.
So as we can see, there is a ton of stuff going on here at the Y, and their grand reopening is until the 28th. So if you're a new member and you're interested, you can come out and you can even get a free tour. You can even join a new class. You can take a class. You can work out for free. So you'll want to come out here and take a look at the new facility here at the YMCA in Grand Forks.
Abby Furchner reporting for us this morning.
Lots of nice changes
up there. All right, stay with us. Coming up, looking for advice on some lifestyle changes. We have a doctor in the house with some great advice on how to feel and look great.